back to Maria and Joe Live TV and the second segment. And this is Maria.
Hey, this is Joe. Thank you, everyone, for joining us once again. And my thanks to Jesse and Joe and Jim for stepping in, and Nancy. Great to see you guys.
Hi, Jesse. Thank you so much for actually tuning in every week with us. And thank you for all our supporters out there who continue to be on air with us. Thank you so much to actually Eric Sugitan, to Joe Berger, to all the people that I couldn't, you know, I normally write down the names and I lost it because you know me.
We
appreciate all you guys' support out there. And by the way, Joe, we're gonna be talking about first is the Mayo de Cinco.
Why start there? Let's start with the important one, May 1st.
Oh, what is May 1st?
May 1st is May Day or Labor Day. It depends on where you are in the world, but May Day started in Europe somewhere. This was brought to my attention last week. At a Toastmasters meeting, someone gave me some flavor because he was giving out a lot of flowers. As he says, back in the day, they would put flowers or gifts or candy on someone's doorknobs, knock on the door, and run. Pretty much like a girl or a guy that you liked, you just kind of put something there and run away and see the response.
Oh, wow.
If you were giving flowers to someone's house, and there were already flowers there from someone else, then you have a problem.
I have no idea. Honestly speaking, I have no idea what you're talking about. But that that's interesting.
It is. You know, the different way that people show one another they like them, and they're afraid to talk face to face. So these little gifts, little candy, maybe knock on the door. Or back in the day, you pick up the phone and call them, and hang up, and they answer. Things we do when we're younger and immature and having fun.
So that's actually when you were younger, right?
Absolutely, a couple of years ago.
Yeah, well, now we don't do that anymore.
We don't do that anymore?
In my age.
In your age? I did that last week. I put some flowers on the doorknob and rang the doorbell and ran. It's true. I did that last week. It's so funny. She almost called the cops because no one was there at the door. It was late at night. So be careful out there.
Yes, be careful out there. So Mayflower, that's pretty cool celebration that I don't hear much, but I love flowers. Mayflower. That's Do they have flower parade kind of thing where they show all the different flowers or something like that?
I live in an area called the flower capital of the world, Lompoc, California, just about a half hour away from me. And once a year, they used to, they have fields of flowers. Actually, they would make the American flag all the side out there. So a majority of the nation's flowers come from the area I live in right now, Lompoc, California. Huge acres, a thousand acres of flowers. So I don't know, whatever kind you like, and I don't know the difference. To me, flowers are flowers.
Yeah, I know, right?
Right. But I do my best.
Well, yeah, well, what's your favorite flower?
I happen to like red carnations. I think red carnations is usually what I would have on as a pal. If I had my suit on, even though I had a red rose all weekend when I was at a convention in Bakersfield, I'm really happy with the carnation. I think it's a beautiful flower.
Yeah, I love the yellow rose.
Yellow rose?
Yes.
Okay. So you buy me a carnation, I'll buy you a rose. Sound fair?
Nope.
Nope.
You can buy me a yellow rose. I'm not gonna buy you anything. But anyways. Anyways, Joe. Okay, so let's go on the second and the next next event. So we had May 1st. Hello?
Hello, are
you there? Okay, so we have May 1st. Do you want to talk more about the May 1st or what do you want?
Well, go on to Cinco de Mayo, like you were talking
about. Yeah, Cinco de Mayo. So what's about it?
Cinco de Mayo is some stupid holiday that Americans celebrate, and it's the day the Mexicans beat the French hundreds of years ago. The Mexicans don't celebrate it, but the Americans do. Just another day to drink.
The Americans celebrate it?
Duh. You're in Vegas. You see it all over. The Mexicans rarely celebrate it. It's not a big deal. It's not a holiday for them like it is for us.
Oh, well, you know what? Yes, I heard it. I had so much invitation for the Cinco de Mayo, and I'm like, what about it? It's all about drinking your Patron. But I think that's what about it. It's Cinco de Mayo, like what you said. You know, there's no such thing, Joe, that is stupid, all right? I believe that there are certain things that has been done or has been made for a reason. It's necessarily, probably it's stupid to some people, but it's not to other people, you know. So we just have to be, you know, be very, very careful of you know, how we actually look at it, because it's not necessarily, you know, we don't want to hurt somebody else's feelings out there. We actually are the media, and we actually are in the middle. It doesn't matter what sides they are. We are in the middle. We are in the media, and we don't want to actually hurt somebody else's feelings out there. I'm really sorry about that. That's not what Joe trying to imply. We are in the media. We are, well, somebody might take it a different way when we said stupid. So I just want to actually apologize about that. So anything could be, you know, we feel it like stupid, but it's an opinionated thing. It's somebody else's opinion. But no, there's no such, like what I said, we're trying to actually just want to celebrate what we want to celebrate. But it doesn't mean yours is stupid and mine is not. It's just actually expression. So I apologize about that. Well, we're gonna go to the next segment, Joe. On the third segment is the.
I'm glad Cinco de Mayo is over.
It's over. It's a few days ago. But you know what? The thing, Joe, is I am glad Cinco de Mayo is over. Now I can actually go look on the next one, right?
That's right. The next one's probably more important to you.
All right. So we're going to talk about that on our third segment. So stand by. If you guys have anything, if you guys want to actually comment or say something about what we are talking about, feel free to do so. This is for everybody, all right? So please stand by. Before I go, I want to say thank you to James Dingle and Robert Rossello for joining us. Thank you. We will be right back on the third segment. Thank you for tuning in. This is Maria.